So here's an entertaining one where a guy has epic level revenge on his fiance after discovering that she secretly was doing OnlyFans. And not just doing OnlyFans and cheating in that aspect and element, but also cheating on him with another dude. Titled, Am I the A-hole for reporting my fiance and her lover to the FBI for credit card fraud on the OnlyFans platform? And a shout to Nishad for sending me the short story. It says, not long ago, I was engaged. My girlfriend seemed like someone you could build a life with. She was beautiful, intelligent, admired, and respected by everyone who knew her. What a great con artist. She always had good ideas and instincts when it came to making money. She was the girl of my dreams, and I genuinely wanted to spend my whole life with her. After 2 years together, I proposed, and we planned to get married in Bali in 2025. Smack! 2 years. That's it. You only knew her 2 years? Well, clearly you didn't really know her. In March of this year, I noticed something off about her behavior. She started coming home 4 to 5 hours late, often with excuses that didn't add up. 4 to 5 hours late? 45 minutes to an hour is stretching it. But 4 to 5 hours, was like, what are you doing for 4 to 5 hours? I mean, bro, tell me you had to be investigating this after like the first incident, let alone this happening a lot. I know she put a privacy screen on her phone, making it impossible to see what she was doing on the phone. She began leaving the house looking like a diva with impeccable makeup, dyeing her hair more frequently, and changing her hairstyle. She had always been well-groomed, but these changes seemed excessive, like something only models and stars do. I felt uneasy, and feelings wouldn't go away. Yes, of course, things are 4 to 5 hours late coming home every day. What do you think she's doing? Driving to, like, two states away and coming back? And dressing differently, behaving differently, locking her phone? These are all classic signs. But when you rush into a relationship with someone, and you're just enamored with him, which he is here, look what happens. So finally, I put an AirTag in her car to track where she was, and she was late. The same day I did this, I saw she was far from home, and her car was parked in a rough area. Rough area? Like a shitty motel? I drove like a madman until I found her car and waited for her to return. After several hours, she came out of a house with a man. Surprise, they kissed passionately as they left. Well, no surprise there that she's cheating on him. But this goes to a whole new level. Despite my anger, I remained calm and decided to talk to her when we got home. I let her leave first so she wouldn't see me and then headed home myself. When I got home, I found her in the kitchen making dinner. Although I was furious during the drive, I managed to stay calm during our confrontation. Good. It's best to stay calm. After several hours of listening to her excuses, tears, and lies, she finally told me the truth. So, trickle truth. Tears, excuses, and lies. Until finally he just wouldn't back down. And by the way, you never got the full truth. She had started a relationship with that guy. He was involved in stealing credit card data from online store customers and convinced her to create an OnlyFans account and other adult live streaming sites. Together, they used stolen credit cards to fund her model accounts and split the profits. Whoa, that's diabolical. Okay, so he steals the credit card info, and then he uses it, then she creates an OnlyFans, and then they act like people paying for it, for these big things, and act like it's legitimate money. Like, she could be like, well, I didn't know where the money was coming from. At my insistence, she showed me her OnlyFans and other accounts. After that, I quietly went to the couch and fell asleep. This poor guy. But, again, this is why you spent a long time getting to know your girl. And the whole big charade she was putting up is bullshit. The next day, I contacted the police and sent an email to the FBI explaining what my fiancé was doing. Well, it's criminal. I'm sure there are guys out here watching this right now, that have had something like this happen to you, where your information was stolen, your credit card, and the whole hassle of having to deal with the chargebacks, and then closing the account, or maybe you had your personal information stolen, and things open up in your name. I mean, she and this a-hole deserve to be behind bars. I didn't tell her anything. I pretended to be upset but passive, and she believed me. Nothing happened for more than a week until one day, police officers knocked on our door and arrested her. 1 month later, the FBI took over the case because her lover was part of a larger online scam group with many victims. A few days ago, I got a call from my ex-fiancée, who is currently out on bail. She accused me of ruining her life, saying I overreacted and should have just broken up with her instead of getting her arrested. Correction, sweetheart. You ruined your life. First, you ruined our relationship and our engagement because you were cheating on me and not being also being a big scammer doing OnlyFans, but also, you are partaking in this knowing full well that he was stealing all this credit card information and partaking in the scam here. Now, I want to ask you all, am I the a-hole in this situation? Should I feel guilty for contacting the police and the FBI? Smack! I can't believe you asked that question, nice guy. No! You did the right thing. She and this a-hole guy deserve to be behind bars. Absolutely. And I'd have nothing to do with her ever again. Now, what I think is going to happen is probably is that she will make a deal with them. Because this guy, he's stealing all the information and people's identities and all that. And obviously he and these other people are already wanted, I guess, with an ongoing investigation. So they're probably going to make a deal with her because although she wasn't going after people's information, she was obviously part of the thing with the money and the whole thing. So I'm willing to bet you that between her tears and the deal making, they'll make her turn on him and she'll get a lesser sentence as long as like maybe she doesn't have any priors or something like that. Hopefully she'll do some jail time, but I don't see how she's going to get the same thing as he does. But regardless, no. She's a piece of garbage and deserves what's happening to her. But of course, she's trying to gaslight, say this guy ruined her life. Bullshit. Good for you, bro. You did the right thing. Many people out there that have been scammed. Thank you for doing that. Okay? And even if he did it because he thought it was the right thing or he did it because he wanted her to suffer, hey, I don't care. Justice is served. Now some comments here. One guy says, not the a-hole. Thank you for doing the right thing. Ex-fiancée saying you ruined her life is ruined is inconsiderate towards victims of stolen credit card information. Another one, not the a-hole at all. She made her bed, blaming you means she's taking no accountability for ripping people off, cheating on you. I hope they throw the book at her and the affair partner. You need to take care of yourself now and rebuild your life without her in it. Another one, I needed this laugh. Scammers are the worst, and so are cheaters. This is the best revenge because justice to others. The significant other to that did that to her. She earned what happened to her. Don't feel the slightest bit of guilt for her bad decisions. I hope you're able to move on from her and the situation. Best of luck, man. Yeah, she's a scammer. And the thing is this, she scammed this guy. You know, she put on the charm and all that, and this is who she really is. Another one. Not the a-hole. She definitely deserved to get reported and caught. She's still hurting other people. I mean, all those people that had to cancel their credit cards and possibly fight with credit cards to get things deleted or having everything screwed up and having to get erased from their credit history. What if they were in the middle of trying to buy a house or getting an apartment and it gets denied because of these idiots? Now she should go to jail for a long time, hopefully. Well, we can all hope that, but I don't think she's going to go for very long because I guarantee you she's going to become... She's going to make a deal with the FBI for this guy and those other guys. Guaranteed. Hopefully she gets to do some behind bars somehow, but probably in a very minimal security thing for like 2 months. I could be wrong. But then it also depends. Well, no, if this becomes a federal issue, it doesn't make a difference where she lives. But hopefully she has to be behind bars for a little while. But this is going to stick with her the rest of her life. But if she's beautiful and attractive, she'll probably just con some guy in the future to marry her. And you know. But a lot of times these people like this don't stop. So anyhow, that'd be a pretty entertaining one here. But this guy definitely handled this like a boss.